President Obama had a press conference scheduled not long after the death of Trayvon Martin. And we were in the Oval Office with him right before he went out to deliver his remarks. And he said to us in a very emotional way, there is a reason why the Black community is so outraged by this death, because he's walking down the street with Skittles in his own neighborhood, and why is he a threat? And then he said, I want you to make sure a reporter asks me about this, even though it's not the topic of the press conference. I want my voice in this.
When I think about this boy, I think about my own kids. My main message is to the parents of Trayvon Martin. You know, if I had a son, he'd look like Trayvon.
And then after the George Zimmerman verdict was announced, the fact that he was exonerated reinforced the sense that the system isn't fair, that law and order doesn't apply equally. And President Obama went down to the briefing room and again, in very emotional tone, said,
Trayvon Martin could have been me 35 years ago. There are very few African-American men in this country who haven't had the experience of being followed when they were shopping in a department store. That includes me. We need to spend some time in thinking about how do we bolster and reinforce our African-American boys. And this is something that Michelle and I talk a lot about. There are a lot of kids out there who need help, who are getting a lot of negative reinforcement. And is there more that we can do to give them a sense that their country cares about them and values them and is willing to invest in them?
And so that led to his team doing a lot of work to come up with the idea of My Brother's Keeper.
I first met Christian about a year ago. I visited the Hyde Park Academy in Chicago, which is only about a mile from my house. And Christian was part of this program called Becoming a Man. And it helps young men who show a lot of potential but may have gotten in some trouble to stay on the right path. They get help with schoolwork, but they also learn life skills. And it works.
When he came into our BAM circle, it was one of the greatest experiences of my life. Most people do not get to meet him, or if they do, it's just a handshake. He sat down with us and shared his story. And to my surprise, he was just like me, growing up without a father, and sometimes not too concerned with school.
I could see myself in these young men. And the only difference is that I grew up in an environment that was a little bit more forgiving. I told these young men my story then, and I repeat it now because I firmly believe that every child deserves the same chances that I had. And that's why we're here today. I'm going to pen this presidential memorandum to determine what we can do right now to improve the odds for boys and young men of color. And we're committed to building on what works. And we call it My Brother's Keeper.